I like getting in routine, so, you know, wake up, make my breakfast.
There's nothing I'm the cleanest guy around.
Walk to my gym. A few guys that I work out with, I used to play college with. It's always good working out with them, and my trainer's great.
You ever heard of that cryotherapy?
You know, then we can, you know, do fun stuff on the weekends. My girlfriend's from the suburbs here, so that kind of what brought us here. Chicago's an awesome city, and it's a great time to spend my off season here. We're gonna go on the river today. It's a beautiful day, so we'll have fun.
You recommend the North or South Branch?
South.
So are you a player?
I am, yeah.
What's your name?
Jake.
McCabe. Sorry, I don't really follow.
No,
hockey.
That's fine. I'm a nobody, so don't worry about it.
Rock and roll, Captain.
All right, Duffer, here we go.
No music?
You guys have a phone? All right, here we go. Oh, geez.
Watch out, you've got a... Scary.
All right, I got too much going on. We're fine, I got her. My heart started beating really fast when I saw that yellow coming right at me.
Jake, where did it all begin?
Eau Claire, Wisconsin. My dad grew up playing hockey. I obviously had to get on the ice as soon as possible for my dad, and I was very fortunate to make teams when I was younger, and my mom always made sure I was humble, and dad brought that, you know, that confidence and competitiveness to me, and you know, you get drafted Buffalo Sabres select Jake McCabe, and then sure enough, you're walking up there and you can't believe it. You've been working your whole life, and then you get drafted and you can finally put on an NHL jersey. I mean, I was fully expecting to be in Rochester, and then there's injuries that happen, and was lucky enough to get a shot and take advantage of that. So it took me 12 games to get a W in a Sabres uniform. Now hopefully there's a lot of W's coming.
Smart circle working on Campbell, sends it in front, they score! McCabe delivered the hit.
I play my best when I'm physical, and it doesn't have to be a big hit, but as long as you're engaged, but the rest of my play usually follows.
Nelson gets tagged by McCabe. Shankly to Slater, and another one was checked by McCabe. And now everybody going after McCabe. That's Patrick Laine, who McCabe hit.
You know, he set on a pass, and then they actually pass it, so you're like, all right, well, put my body into him. But I'm just glad he was okay. I mean, really, I'm just glad he came back in a couple weeks. Biggest thing that came out of it was just the media attention that I don't usually garner.
Thanks, Jake. Jake, was the cut off the hit itself, or what happened after?
Yeah, it was right initially on the hit. I think we might have gone head to head. I haven't seen a replay of it, but.
You know, I'm obviously not a huge high profile player, but he is, so I had a lot of Winnipeg fans that weren't happy with me.
How badly hurt were you?
I came back that same game. I had a lot of stitches in my face. I've been very lucky with a lot of things. 2 years ago, I was pegged to be in Rochester. I was lucky enough to get a shot. And I think it's time for us younger guys to kind of step up. I think it's crucial to be leaders in the team and organization. So, you know, we've had a couple years in the league now, and every time I watch Stanley Cup getting raised, it's, you know, you're jealous. I think that's what drives me the most, is trying to finally raise that thing, and for Buffalo too, really. We all want to win for their fans, want to win for the city, because they've been so close. We weren't a great team last year, but they still came and supported us, and you know, they were frustrated along with us, so we're all in it for the same reason, to win, and I think it's time for us to make that next step.
We got some breaking news that the Sabres have traded for Jason Pominville, Marco Scandella, bringing back Jason Pominville, character player.
He's the true professional. That's why he was one of the captains here in Buffalo when he played.
I think I was making breakfast or eating breakfast one morning, and actually my brother texted me and said, hey, it looks like you're switching back to 19.
So I thought, I'm like, oh, what is he talking about? So then I looked on Twitter. You know, Palmer, he's worn it his career, and I didn't know he was captain here, and I know there's still a lot of 29 Palmerville jerseys that walk around this town. So once that happened, I kind of just realized it's probably better that he took 29, and I was happy to go back to 19 anyways. It was my college number, so. He texted me shortly after and, you know, said, hey, you really don't need to do that. Like, I appreciate it, but it's unnecessary. And I said, no, it's, it really works out. It's, I like 19 anyways. And he's like, all right, I guess I gotta buy you dinner or something to make it up to you. You know, we're all pretty excited. We've had a long off season. We're sick of lifting weights. I think it's kind of start to, you know, just play hockey now. And I know I'm really looking forward to it, and so are the other guys.
Beyond Blue and Gold is presented by New Era, the official cap of the Buffalo Sabres.